day everyone. This lesson we are going to discuss about migration and urbanization. So what is migration? So people move from one place to another place is called as migration. For example, now you are living in your house. After the holidays, you are going to your grandmother house. So it is called as migration because you are moving from one place to another place. And next one is urbanization. Urban means city. Rural means village. So those people moving to city and that city is changed to urban. Okay. Because most of the people they are settling in city side. So it is called as urbanization. Urbanization means city. Okay. For example, Chennai, Coimbatore, Tiruchi, Salem. So these are example for the urbanization. Urban means city. Okay. So this class we are going to discuss about migration. So what is migration? So as we discussed already, people move from another place is called as migration. They are moving from one place to another place is called as migration. So this migration may be permanent or semi-permanent. Okay. So this migration may be permanent or semi-permanent is called as migration. Okay. So people residence. Residence means they're settling down. Moving from other place, they're settling down is called as migration. It may be permanent or semi-permanent. Okay. So according to UNO, what is UNO? United National Organization. So according to UNO, this definition, migration is a form of geographical mobility. Mobility means moving from one place to another. So mobility of population between a geographical unit to another, generally involving the permanent change of residence. One of the most aspect of the social science is human migration. One of the most aspect of social science is human migration. Because in social science what we learned, history. If you take the history, our ancient people move from one place to another place and settle one place as we have studied in social science. That is called as nomadic life. Now people are settled in one place. But the ancient people, they move from one place to another place purpose of hunting, food gathering. Yes or no? We studied in lower class. Okay. So they are not settled one place as they move from other place. Mostly they live in jungles. In the jungles they hunt the animal. So that after over the animal they move from one place to another place. So most aspect of social science we have studied about human migration. The ancient period the people move from one place to another place is called as nomadic life. Okay, it's called as nomadic life. So nomadic life means they didn't settle one place, they move from other places for searching of food. So that life is called as nomadic life. And they live in jungle so that they adopted their domesticate animals. They adopted domesticate animals, cattle, dog, hen. So this all they adopted because people settled and lived in jungle. Okay. So people move from one place to another place. Later they are settled in riverside. Okay. So people later they settle in riverside and they know about the civilization life. They started the civilization life. They started the cultivation. Because people settle in riverside, so they got the idea about the fertile soil, water, and they started the cultivation. So before people move from one place to another place is called as nomadic life. And people settle in one place and they started their cultivation as another life. It is called as residency. So this movement from one place to another place is called as migration. So migration occurs not only ancient period, at present also if you are moving from other place also is called as migration. Okay. So this migration based on semi-migration or permanent migration. Semi means if you are settling 6 months or 1 year for job purpose, again you are going to come your native place. Or if you are settling permanently or settled in your places, for example, Coimbatore or any other country. Permanently, if you settle means is called as permanent settlement, permanent migration. Okay, the short term, the migration means people move from one place to another place. Okay. And next one is reasons for migration. Next one is reasons for migration. Reasons for migration. So two important reasons for the migration is, one is push factor, another one is pull factor. Okay, so two important types of migration is push factors, another one is pull factors. So very simple, push. If you are going the ground or any other place, father, student, they are pushing means you will fall down. Okay, it is push factor, just pushing others is called as push. And pull means just pulling the person or any door or anything is called as pull. Okay, pushing means just pushing, and pull means you are pulling is called as pull factor. So this is two important reason for the migration. One is push factors, another one is pull factors. For example, if I am in Namakkal, okay, if I am in Namakkal, here if I am facing any war, okay, any war, any battle or any disaster like a flood or volcanoes, earthquake, so any other this natural disaster or war or poverty. Poverty means very hungry, okay, we are not able to earn the money for our daily purpose. So poverty, so this any reason if I faced, so I can't, I could not stay here means if I'm moving to other place is called as push factor. This reason is pushing from this place to another place. Okay, so example, poverty or any tsunami. Okay, so any other reason, war. So this is the reason for the push factor. So pushing from this place to pushing to other place. We said already push means just pushing the person, just pushing. So that this is the reason pushing from this this area to other area is called as push factor. Okay, example, poverty, tsunami, war, flood, any natural disaster. Okay, so this area is not suitable for staying. So that reason moving to other place. For example, if you take Jammu and Kashmir, often they are facing the war. So that people, they cannot live peacefully. They can't live peacefully. So that the people are trying to come other area. So this is reason for pushing factor. Next one is pull factor. Other area, it is attracting to go there. For example, if I am in Namakkal, but if you see the Chennai or Coimbatore, they are developed in education, more colleges, then for entertainment, park, and theaters, malls. So like that, more facilities available in urban areas, developed areas. So that is pulling, that is attracting to come there. Okay, so this is compulsory, this is the reason it is pushing. That is attracting, for attraction, for highest it is, anyway you are going to Chennai or Coimbatore. So that is one of the pull factor. And next one is any other entertainment, for if you see the mall or any colleges or any theaters. So like some reason it is attracting is called as pull factor. Okay, it is called as pull factor. So this pull factor may be food or city life. So mostly two reasons you are going to city side. One is, for example, is food. Then education. So main reason is education, and another reason is job. So job purpose. So if you want to go to the IT company, means so you want to try only the Coimbatore or Chennai in Tamil Nadu. So that is one of the pull factor. So anyway, they are moving from this place to that place. Okay. So example is education, for job purpose, then food. So that city life. Some people they like city life. Some people they like only the village life. So most of the people, they are moving the city life end of their life, or after retirement, 60 years old, after 58 years old, after the retirement, again they are coming to the village life. Okay, so again they are coming to the village life. So the migration means moving from one place to another place. The reason of the migration is push factor, pull factor. The example of push factor is poverty, natural disaster, war. An example for pull factor is education for job purpose and food purpose. So this is the reason people moving from one place to another place, may be permanent or semi-permanent. Okay, so this this urbanization is called as permanent. Again after retirement, again they come to their own native place is called as semi-permanent. Next, learn and write the answer. Your question is define migration. Migration means move from one place to another place. Next one, what is called pull factor, and give some example. The example of pull factor is education and etc. And next one is what is called push factors, and give some examples. So poverty, war. So these are example for the push factors. Okay, I hope you understood this session very well. Next class we are going to discuss about types of migration. Thank you, have a nice day.